granny man. Count it on like the handyman. Scared of me, I'm candy man. Wristbands, I'm fancy man. Well known like the anchor man. Bitch in some danger man. Walk into the plate, I look at coach, he say he hanging down. Tough as nails, I'm made of them. Big bat,
the hello everyone and welcome to the Leadoff, your daily news and highlight show for everything baseball related. I'm your host, Dawson Wright, and let's go ahead and get started. So during yesterday's video, I said that Shohei Ohtani needed Tommy John surgery. And shortly after I uploaded the video, the Angels GM and the manager said that Shohei Ohtani didn't need Tommy John surgery. And I do apologize for that, but the story came from ESPN that Shohei Ohtani for sure needed Tommy John surgery and would probably be out for about the next 2 years. And does he need Tommy John yet? There is no confirmation from the Angels. But ESPN decided to run the story and they lied about it. They straight up lied about it. They did not have confirmation from the Angels, obviously, but they just had to run the story anyway. And it's pretty sad that ESPN decided to run the story, but in good news, we don't know if Shohei Ohtani for sure needs Tommy John surgery yet. And then if he doesn't, then he could hopefully get back and play soon. For our next story of the day, we're going to talk a little college baseball as Florida defeated Auburn to advance to the College World Series. Florida won on a walk-off homer from Austin Langworthy that hit off right fielder Stephen Williams' glove. That game completes the College World Series bracket, which now looks like this. The first game will be Oregon State versus North Carolina this Saturday. Now let's go ahead and get into all the highlights from yesterday's action. Rays and Blue Jays at the trop. Teoscar Hernandez at the plate. That's a two-run shot. Blue Jays lead 3-1. Bottom three, Adames singles to left. Now it's 3-2 Jays. Bottom four, Rays down 4-3. Jake Bowers at the plate. That's a two-run shot to right. His first major league homer. And the Rays would go on to win 8-4. Giants and Marlins starting their four-game series in Miami. Ryan Anderson at the plate. That's a two-run homer into right center, and the Marlins take a one-run lead. Top five, McCutchen doubles down the line, Hernandez scores, and this game is tied. Bases loaded, Chen balks, and the Giants take a 3-2 lead. Nets batter Nick Hundley takes ball four, and now it's 4-2 Giants. Sixth inning, Brinson with a base hit to left, and this game is tied. Bumgarner is being taken out of the game, exchanges a few words with the home plate umpire, and then gets tossed. Bottom 7, Real Muto hits a 2-run homer to center, and the Marlins would go on to win 7-5. Indians and White Sox, top of the 4th, Yan Gomes doubles down the line, 2-run score, 3-0 Indians, and that's all Carlos Carrasco would need as he strikes out 11, and the Indians win 4-0. Cardinals and Padres in St. Louis, we pick this up in the 3rd, Jose Martinez hits one into center, that's a 2-run shot, his 5th in 5 games. Bottom 5, Ozuna hits one into left, that's another 2-run homer. Cardinals take a 4-1 lead, and they would go on to win by a score of 5-2. Orioles and Red Sox, top of the 12th, they are still tied at 0, bases loaded for Brock Holt. Holt hits a sac fly to center, the run would score, bottom of the 12th, Kimbrel on for the save and he would get it, and the Red Sox win. D-Bats and Pirates in the desert, 5-0 Pirates in the top of the 7th, Nick Ahmed hits one into left and the run would score. Santana into pitch now, and Jaith Lamb hits one into left, and we are all tied at 5. Bottom 8, that's a wild pitch, and the D-Bats now lead 6-5, and they would go on to win 9-5. Cubs Brewers in Milwaukee, Hayward hits a base hit to right, Zobrist scores, and we are all tied at 2. Top of the 11th, Rizzo crushes one into right field, the Cubs take a 3-2 lead, and they would go on to score 4 more runs in that inning as they win 7-2. Mariners and Angels, top of the 1st, that's a solo homer from Mike Trout, surprise, surprise. Bottom of the 1st, Cruz responds with a 2-run shot and we're all tied at 2. Bottom 4, game still tied, how about another one for the boomstick? Mariners lead 3-2. Same inning, Ryan Healy hits a 2-run homer to left, the Mariners now have a 3-run lead. Top 8, Mike Trout hits a 2nd homer of the day, but the Mariners top the Angels 5-3. That'll do it for all the news and highlights from yesterday. I know this was a shorter episode, but there was less games and less things to talk about. But I will see you guys in the next episode.